Hare Krishna, Bhagavad Gita 40.19 Nayam gunevya kartaram yadadastanu pasyati gunevya saparam veti madbhavam sodigacchati. When one properly sees that in all activities no other performer is at work than these modes of nature, and he knows the Supreme Lord, who is transcendental to all these modes, he attains my spiritual nature. So, it brings up to the point, what is my position? This verse says, there is no other performer than the three modes of material nature. Who is in control? Everything is done by material nature. Lord Krishna says in this world. Who controls material nature? It's Paramatma, the super soul, Maya Dakshina Prakriti, is the superintendent of material nature. He knows our past activities and he awards us reactions exactly befitting our past activities. So, what is my position? You have no control over material nature. It's like you don't have control over a dream. You dream at night. In the morning you get up and say, oh, it's just a dream. But you were the observer in the dream. You could not control it. So, in our awakened or so-called awakened state, we are experiencing a collective dream. It starts with birth and it ends with death of the body. And during that period of this lifetime, everyone is identifying with the body. But this is not a platform of reality because we are not the body. The platform of reality is on the spiritual platform that what we see, what we consider as reality, that is according to our sense perception. What we see, we consider our reality, but there is a broader picture. There is a subtle nature that brings up the question, how did we become entangled in this dream? How can we liberate ourselves from it? It's by transcendental knowledge. In the Bhagavad Gita, what Krishna explains, that what binds us, what liberates us, that if we perform activities and we are attached to the result, we become entangled. If we perform activities for the pleasure of Krishna, we disentangle ourselves. So this knowledge is subtle. We need subtle knowledge to cut this bondage. Bondage is due to our desires to enjoy in this world a body which we are not, which is kind of insanity, that to enjoy separate from Krishna. And to rectify that, we need knowledge to identify again as our real self and act as our real self. This knowledge is described in Bhagavad Gita as Jnana Pravrana, a boat of transcendental knowledge that by which we can cross the ocean of nations in which we identify with this dream. Because we identify with the body, we identify with the mind, we suffer. We think the suffering that comes up in the mind, that's me, the happiness, that's my reality, but it's not. Krishna says we have to become the observer. But for this, we have first to exchange our desire. Give up this desire to enjoy this material world. And that can be done by knowledge. Knowledge from Bhagavad Gita, which explains the futility of material nature. It explains our real nature and how we can realize it. That's the power of knowledge. It's like a bridge between the material and the spiritual world. So it's important that we take to this bridge. That in Bhagavad Gita, this knowledge, at the end of the fourth chapter, Krishna explains it's the most sublime knowledge. And that knowledge, if we can apply it, will bring about spiritual peace and ultimate perfection or self-realization. Therefore, it's important that we realize our position and take control, the control of our minds, that and control of our life, that so that we come to our real existence, the platform of loving Krishna. Thank you very much.